Good morning. In this session, I shall be discussing about the sexual reproduction in Anthoceras. This topic is included in the unit Bryophytes of the second semester. I am Shobha Rani, Assistant Professor, Department of Botany, Government First Grade College, Chikbalapur. Before understanding the sexual reproduction in Anthoceras, let us have a recap of the previous session. Anthoceras grows on moist soil. They are present in shady places or in the crevices of rocks. Anthoceras erectus, Anthoceras himalayensis, and Anthoceras chambensis are commonly found in western Himalayas. The gametophytic plant body is thalloid, dorsiventral, prostrate, dark green in color. It is lobed and is irregular and has a tendency towards dichotomous branching. The lobes have a wavy margin. Anthoceras form small rosette-like plant. Unicellular rhizoids are attached to the underside of the thallus. Small mucilaginous cavities are present on the ventral side. These cavities contain colonies of blue-green alga like nostoc. Stomata-like small slates are present on the thallus. Mucilage oozes out through these slits. Internal structure of the thallus shows that the thallus has uniform tissue of parenchymatous cells. Epidermis is present on both sides. The cell contains the chloroplast. Generally, each cell contains a single chloroplast. Each chloroplast has a pyrenoid. The thallus is thickest in the middle. It gradually becomes thinner towards the margins. Cells of the lower epidermis gives rise to smooth unicellular rhizoids. Anthoceras reproduces by vegetative and sexual methods. Vegetative reproduction takes place by following methods. By death and decay of the older portion of the thallus or fragmentation, by formation of tubers, by formation of gymae, by persistent growing apices, and by apospore. Now if we look into the sexual reproduction in Anthoceras, sexual reproduction is oogamous. Male reproductive bodies are known as antheridia, while the female reproductive bodies are known as archegonia. Anthoceras has both monoecious and dioecious species. Male plants are smaller than the female in dioecious species. Some species of Anthoceras, like Anthoceras longi, Anthoceras gulani, Anthoceras fusiformis, Anthoceras punctatus, Anthoceras crepulus, and Anthoceras himalayensis are monoecious, while some species like Anthoceras erectus, Anthoceras chambensis, Anthoceras halli, Anthoceras piersoni, and Anthoceras levis are dioecious. The monoecious species are protandrous, that is, antheridia mature before archegonia. The sex organs are deeply embedded in the thallus. When we look into the antheridium of the Anthoceras, the antheridia are present on the upper side of the thallus in small cavities. Antheridia are developed in clusters from the hypodermal cells of the thallus and are enclosed in a roofed antheridial chamber. That is, the antheridial cavities are completely covered by a double layer of cells. They have no opening to the outside. As we can observe here, a mature antheridium has a stalk and a globose or club-shaped or a pouch-like body. The stalk attaches the antheridium to the base of the antheridial chamber. Stalk may be slender and composed of four rows of cells like in Anthoceras punctatus and Anthoceras erectus, or it may be more massive as in Anthoceras levis. A single or a group of 2 to 4 or more antheridia are present in the same antheridial chamber. A single layered jacket encloses the mass of androcytes. The cells of the jacket layer are sterile. The androcytes metamorphoses into antherozoids or the male gametes. In some species, for example, in Anthoceras punctatus and Anthoceras erectus, jacket layer is formed of 4 tiers of cells. Each tier appears to be composed of elongated rectangular cells. In Anthoceras levis and Anthoceras himalayensis, jacket is composed of many relatively smaller and less regularly arranged cells. The cells of the uppermost tiers are triangular with a narrow end towards the apex. Each cell of the jacket consists of plastids. At maturity, these plastids change their color from green to red to bright orange. Young antheridia are therefore green and mature one turn bright orange or reddish. If you look into the antherozoids, a mature antherozoid is unicellular, uninucleate, biflagellated, and has a linear body. The flagella are of almost the same length as the body. Now if we move on to the dehiscence of the antheridium, water helps in the dehiscence of antheridium. As the antheridia mature, the roof of the antheridial chamber breaks down irregularly, exposing the antheridia in a cup-like chamber. The antheridia absorb water and the uppermost tier of the triangular cells fall apart, releasing a mass of anthrozoids. After dehiscence, the antheridium loses turgor and collapses. Now if we look into the archegonia develops embedded in the tissue of the thallus on dorsal surface. The place of an archegonium on the thallus can be identified by a presence of mucilage mound. A mature archegonium consists of 2 to 4 cover cells, an axial row of 4 to 6 neck canal cells, a ventral canal cell, and an egg. The jacket layer is not distinct from other vegetative cells like in other bryophytes. Now let us look into the fertilization. Water is essential for fertilization. In mature archegonium, the ventral canal cell, neck canal cells disintegrate and form a mucilaginous mass. It absorbs water, swells up, and comes out of the archegonial neck by pushing the cover cells apart. This mucilaginous mass becomes continuous with the mucilage mound, and in this way an open passage down to the egg is formed. The mucilaginous mass consists of chemical substances. Many anthrozoids or the male gametes caught in the mucilage enter in the archegonial neck because of the chemotactic response, reach up to the egg, and fertilization is affected. Prior to fertilization, egg enlarges and fills the cavity of the ventre. Fusion of both male and female nuclei result in the formation of diploid zygote or oospore. Fertilization ends the gametophytic phase. So now we'll look into the summary of sexual reproduction in Anthoceras. Anthoceras has both monoecious and dioecious species. Male plants are smaller than the female in dioecious species. In monoecious species, The Antheridia are produced earlier than Archegonia. The sex organs are deeply embedded in the thallus. The Antheridia are present on the upper side of the thallus in small cavities. They are formed in groups of 2 to 4. The antheridial cavities are completely covered by a double layer of cells. They have no opening to the outside. Each antheridium is borne on a multicellular stalk. The main body of the antheridium is globose. It has a single-celled thick jacket. Antheridia have mass of andrigonial cells or androcytes. The androcytes gives rise to biflagellate antherozoids. Archegonia are produced close to the growing point. Archegonia are embedded in the tissue of the thallus. Each archegonium consists of an egg and a venter canal cell and 4 neck canal cells. The canal of the archegonium is closed at the top by 4 cover cells. These cells project slightly above the general surface of the thallus. The plant becomes wet with dew or rain during fertilization. The anthrozoites are attracted towards the archegonium chemotactically. Anthrozoites enter the archegonium through the neck canal. One of the anthrozoites fuses with the egg to complete the fertilization. The zygote increases in size and completely fills the venter. It secretes a wall to become the oospore. So, this was about the brief description of sexual reproduction in Anthoceros. Thank you.